His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al-Khalifa issued Royal Order No. 16 for this year, establishing the Royal Fund for Fallen Servicemen. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al-Khalifa paid a visit today to the Royal Bahrain Air Force, the RBAF, premises. Upon his arrival to the Isa Air Base, His Majesty was received by the Commander-in-Chief of the Bahrain Defense Force, Field Marshal Sheikh Khalifa bin Ahmed Al-Khalifa, Minister of Defense Affairs, BDF Chief of Staff, and Commander of the Royal Bahrain Air Force. A number of senior officers greeted His Majesty the King, then the national anthem was played. His Majesty the King then inspected the guards of honor.
سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة، يتشرف قائد سلاح الجو الملكي البحريني اللواء الركن طيار حمد بن عبد الله آل خليفة بإلقاء كلمته بهذه المناسبة.
After reciting verses from the Holy Quran, the RBF Commander Air Vice Marshal Sheikh Hamad bin Abdullah Al Khalifa delivered a speech expressing his thanks for His Majesty's visit. He hailed His Majesty the King's directives of participating in the operation's decisive storm and restoring hope in Yemen, alongside the Saudi-led Arab coalition aiming at restoring legitimacy in the country. He also hailed His Majesty's constant support to the RBAF and praised his directives alongside the GCC leaders to develop GCC armies through providing the latest equipment in the military field. Sheikh Hamad bin Abdullah Al-Khalifa thanked His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Premier, Prince Salman bin Hamad Al-Khalifa for his constant follow-up. He also extended his thanks to the BDF Commander-in-Chief for his directives that aim to develop the RBAF on all levels.
والتي قادتها بكل كفاءة واقتدار الشقيقة الكبرى المملكة العربية السعودية وذلك لإعادة الشرعية للجمهورية اليمنية وحكومتها المعترف بها دوليا. سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة، لم تكن هذه المشاركة لتتحقق لولا دعم جلالتكم المستمر والمتواصل خلال مسيرة سلاح الجو الملكي البحريني على مدى 40 عام من عمر السلاح، والذي وضع جلالتكم بذرته الأولى وقد أثمرت نخبة من أبناكم رجال البواسل الذين صادقوكم العهد من بعد الله سبحانه وتعالى وما زالوا يقاتلون في ساحات العمليات حتى هذه اللحظة. سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة، إن مظلة دول مجلس التعاون الخليجي قد بلغت مراحل من التقدم في المجال العسكري، فشملت الإسناد والدفاع عن الحقوق العربية والتي أثمرت من خلالها تشكيل التحالف العربي ثم التحالف الإسلامي. ولقد كانت توجيهات جلالتكم السامية مع أخوانكم أصحاب الجلالة والسمو قادة دول مجلس التعاون الخليجي المتعلقة بتطوير الجيوش دول مجلس التعاون كي تصل لأعلى مستويات التكامل الدفاعي، وذلك بتوفير أحدث المنظومات والأسلحة ثم متابعة التدريبات والمناورات بين الجيوش الخليجية، قد أسهم في النجاح الباهر الذي حققته عملية عاصفة الحزم وإعادة الأمل والتي نشهد اليوم مراحلها الأخيرة. إن هذه العملية أكسب سلاح الجو الملكي البحريني الخبرة الكبيرة وأعلى الجاهزية القتالية، والتي هيئت أبنائكم لأي واجب تأمرون جلالتكم بتنفيذه مستقبلاً. واسمحوا لي يا سيدي قبل الختام أن أتقدم إلى سيدي صاحب السمو الملكي الأمير سلمان بن حمد بن عيسى آل خليفة ولي العهد نائب القائد الأعلى والنائب الأول لرئيس مجلس الوزراء بالشكر الجزيل وعظيم امتنان لاهتمامه ومتابعة سمو حفظ الله لأبنائه مرتب سلاح الجو الملكي البحرين. كما نتقدم إلى سيدي صاحب المعالي المشير الركن الشيخ خليفة بن أحمد بن سلمان آل خليفة القائد العام لقوات دفاع البحرين بجزيل الشكر على توجيهات معاليه ومتابعة أبنائه اليومية خلال سير العمليات. ختاما ندعو الله العزيز القدير أن يتقبل شهدانا ممن قضوا نحبهم دفاعاً عن الوطن الغالي بواسع رحمته، وأن ينصر أبناءكم المرابطين في ميدان العزة والكرامة، شاكرين جلالتكم منحنا هذه الفرصة للمثول أمام جلالتكم، مبتهلين لله العلي القدير أن يمدكم بالصحة والعافية وأن يطيل بأعماركم ويبغيكم ذخراً لهذا الوطن الغالي. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة، يتشرف الآن الوكيل الأول هشام أحمد الشروقي بإلقاء قصيدة شعرية بعنوان في الأفق.
Then First Agent Hisham al-Shirugi recited a poem on the occasion.
ثم بدت شمس المعزة على الوعد وفي سلاح الجو صار اليوم عيد عيد شوفت راعي الفرحة حمد. في الأفق لاحت تباشير السعد ثم بدت شمس المعزة على الوعد وفي سلاح الجو صار اليوم عيد عيد شوفت راعي الفرحة حمد. في الأفق اسمه خيوط من ذهب للثريا سابق النجمة وصعد بالولا ثم العطاء والتضحيات اسم بو سلمان والعالم شهد. ويوم نادانا المنادي للنفير وانتخى منه على الفزعة حشد بالكرامة والشهامة والعلا لبت البحرين والكل لا تحد. حتى في الأخبار قالوا عن جيوش بين كل الجند الأقوى الأشد. قلت أبو سلمان قايد للعلا وللبطولة والمراجل والجلد، الشهادة هي لنا أسمى طموح والكرامة مبتغانا للأبد. ما نبي الإعجاب، ما نبي الإعجاب، بل نبغى الشموخ، هذا ما بغانا ولا غيره بعد. ارتقينا فوق هامات الجبال وامتطينا عاديات تستعد، ثم دحرنا حنا واخوان لنا اللي شاف الهول منا وارتعد. ما درى من وين ياتيها الجحيم، ذاك من اسود وجهه من الحسد، ما بقى منه ولا شر ونقير، انتهى وبعونة الفرد الصمد. حنا مع اخواننا رابطة حزام، حنا مع اخواننا ذخر وسند، مقتدين بقادة شم عظام، مهتدين بحكمة العاهل حمد، مهتدين بحكمة العاهل حمد.
His Majesty the King honored a number of officers, non-commissioned officers, and members of the Bahrain Royal Air Force for performing their national duties. He hailed BDF's unit's participation alongside the Saudi led Arab coalition in the operations Restoring Hope to protect the rights and legitimacy of Yemen and provide humanitarian relief as part of Bahrain's duty towards the brotherly country. He also praised the contributions of the Bahrain Royal Air Force and the UN in maintaining security and peace in the region. He hailed the high efficiency of the Air Force and the courage of its members in assuming their duties. He stressed the importance of enhancing the Air Force and providing it with the latest weapons and equipment, in addition to developing arms and weapons of the BDF in order to protect the national march and achieve progress in all fields, wishing all members continued success.
سيدي صاحب الجلالة! يعيش سيدي صاحب الجلالة!
His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa issued Edict No. 18 for this year, appointing Khalil Abdurrasul Hassan Bouchiri as Director of Legal Research and Studies in the Ministry of Parliament Affairs. His Royal Highness also issued Edict No. 19, appointing Nawal Jum'a Ja'far Al Mandil, the Director of Job Assessment Directorate of the Civil Services Bureau, to become the Director of Financial Resources and Service in the Electricity and Water Authority. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa received today at Glabia Palace the Arab Finance and Economic Ministers, in addition to governors of Arab central banks, participating in the joint annual meeting of Arab financial institutions hosted by the kingdom under His Royal Highness's patronage. He highlighted the necessity of holding Arab meetings and conferences in order to address the economic challenges due to the decrease of oil prices. He also noted the importance of enhancing cooperation and coordination between Arab countries in order to form new visions that aim to overcome all economic challenges that face the region. The Prime Minister affirmed the Kingdom's supportive stance to all efforts aiming at enhancing Arab cooperation in the economic and financial fields and enhancing its ability to tackle all economic developments on both regional and international levels. He affirmed the importance of joint annual meetings of Arab financial institutions for its contribution in funding Arab projects, as well as for its role of adopting initiatives that aim to participate in the development march of Arab countries. His Royal Highness then highlighted the participants' success in achieving the best interest for Arab countries. For their part, participants of the meeting thanked the Prime Minister for his patronization of the event, which reflects his keenness to enhance cooperation between Arab countries. Representatives of Her Majesty the King for Charity Works and Youth Affairs, Chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports, and President of the Bahrain Olympic Committee, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, said as he arrived to South Africa to lead the Bahraini team that the Ironman Championship, which will be held next week, is considered a very strong opportunity in many aspects, motivating participants to achieve high positions. He affirmed Bahrain's team's readiness for this championship as they conducted intensive training and also confirmed Bahrain's position internationally and its ability to make more accomplishment. The Minister of Interior, Lieutenant General Sheikh Rashid bin Abdullah Al-Khalifa, received retired Lieutenant General, Governor of Hawali Province in Kuwait, and President of the International Police Sports Union, Sheikh Ahmed Nawaf Al-Sabah, in the presence of the Interior Ministry Undersecretary, Major General Khalid Salim Al-Absi. The Minister of Interior hailed the brotherly consolidated ties between both countries and their keenness to enhance GCC cooperation. The meeting discussed means of developing the police sports field through enhancing cooperation and coordination between international unions. Sheikh Ahmed Nawaf Al-Sabah presented the Minister of Interior with the USIP's top medal in recognition for his remarkable support to the police sports field and for Bahrain's numerous achievements in USIP's activities. The U.S. Secretary of State John Kerry arrived in the kingdom on an official visit where he will hold meetings with His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa, and His Royal Highness the Crown Prince Deputy Supreme Commander First Deputy Premier Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa. Kerry will also hold talks with the Minister of Foreign Affairs. The U.S. Secretary of State was received by the Minister of Foreign Affairs, Sheikh Khalid bin Ahmed bin Hamad Al Khalifa. Sheikh Khalid bin Ahmed voiced pride in the visit of by John Kerry to the kingdom, which reflects the high level of historic and bilateral relations between the two countries and the keen desire of both sides to bolster them in the various fields for the interests of both nations. Such visit, he added, will also reflect positively on the security and stability of the region. On the sidelines of his visit to the kingdom, John Kerry will take part in the joint ministerial meeting with the GCC ministers of foreign affairs.